Welcome to one of the hottest competitions in the chill of the snow. I'm Tom Kirkland, and Olympic Channel's continuing our connection to great Olympic blasts from the past, taking these epic two-hour-plus Olympic events and boiling them down to a very tidy 25 to 30 minutes for your consuming pleasure. This one is Pyeongchang 2018, ladies sometimes crazy, always entertaining snowboard cross competition, quarterfinals, semifinals, and gold medal final over this course in Pyeongchang's Phoenix Snow Park Mountain venue. Postcard, perfect day. Obviously, the spectators are enjoying this. The conditions are epic, and there are the numbers for you. Athletes, fans, support crew, everybody happy with how this day looks. And this is what faces the 24 snowboard athletes from 12 nations here in the snowboard cross knockout rounds. It is from on high. This gives you a great look as the fans wait in eager anticipation of the first quarterfinal. This Phoenix Snow Park track is almost 1,300 meters long. And there you go as we drill down. Many, many intricate features, including several potentially devastating bank turns that will test the best, and a vert drop of 240 meters from a 910-meter start to the 670-meter finish. And certainly all the stars are out today. The young lady with her lucky charm, the patriotic magic marker mustache and beard, is defending Olympic gold medalist, reigning world champion Eva Samkova from the Czech Republic. Here are the rest of the starters in the quarterfinal. Number one, remember, top three advance to the semifinals. Time does not matter. Off they go. These finely tuned athletes will reach speeds of 70 to 80 kilometers per hour as they go. Off the start, Samkova in yellow pants, right where she wants to be. The key here is the time doesn't matter. Top three is where you want to be. You just got to avoid catastrophe, basically. Spectacular run. Just feeding off each other. Getting a little draft from in front, if you're lucky. There's Yakova from Bulgaria in first, but not for long because this is four racers for three spots. There's some ladies behind, but basically as they head down the final jumps to the straightaway, starting to thin out now, and it looks like one, two, three, right there. Final jump. Crowd welcoming the three qualifiers for the semifinals. There you have it. Bulgaria's Yakova, Czech Republic Samkova, the defending gold medalist. And right here, a little miss on the knuckle bump. And third is Moan Lacoz of France. Obligatory wave, the smiles. If you're liking this, let us know in the chat box or down below. Fans certainly eager as we go right back up to the top of the hill, quarterfinal number two. Remember, top three. Second quarterfinal, the USA's Lindsay Jacobellis. Of course, everybody knows her story was this close to a gold medal in the first event in Turin, but kind of a little bit of a showboat act right at the end cost her a gold. She managed to get across the line in time for the silver, but certainly she would like nothing better than to grab the gold 12 years later. Critchlow will be right there. Bergerman. And right off the top, there is some trouble. You really have to maintain momentum. And right here, first one down is Charlotte Banks from France, and then there's more trouble. Nice bit of work there by the Swiss Casanova, but Canada's Bergerman and Maria Vasiltsova of the Olympic athletes from Russia both off their boards and down, but believe it or not, none of the fallen are out of this race. Meantime, up top, Jacobellis and Critchlow loving the solitude out in front. Basically, if they work in tandem, don't get in each other's way. There's two qualifiers for the semifinals, and no traffic from behind, no chance for a problem. Meantime, as they conjugate that tight turn, back to the final four, one spot available for the final four. And as I said, despite what it looked like in the first 10 or 15 seconds of this quarterfinal, all four of the ladies in the back are still viable for that third spot in the semifinals. 1-2, really, again, no drama here. But who's going to come in third? Well, at this point, it is Zoe Bergerman of Canada. And you're going to immediately see that the French border, Charlotte Bunks, is finished way behind. And over to your left, she is not holding back on the emotion. Very, very upset. But stay tuned, because, you know, the officials have to go over the mayhem at the top, look at it through video review, and make a determination. And the only ones who are assured of moving on at this point are 1 and 2, and that is Jacobellis and Critzlow. And here's the problem. Right off the bat, Bonks up the top is down. And then you'll see Bergerman and Vasilsova go down, and nice bit of work again by Casanova to avoid this trouble right there. Casanova does not figure in any of the judgments, but watch on the far right. Bergerman thinks that she might be in trouble, and in fact, she's called off the podium. And who is bumped up to third and a spot in the semifinals? Charlotte Bunks. Tears just a few moments ago. Such is the way it is sometimes in snowboard cross. Back up to the top we go. The one to watch, France's Chloe Trespuch, won bronze in Sochi, in great form here. They are officially out of pregame mode. They are in to their event, and it's all on the line right now. Right off the bat, it's a tough start for the USA's Faye Gulini. Meantime, the next five are on their way, and we'll keep an eye on this. There could be more carnage to come. Megan Tierney in the thick of it, the second American racer in this event. Gulini is pretty much done because of her rough start. There is Trespuch, no problem. Tierney in good shape. Paul of the Olympic athletes from Russia, also sitting nicely, but fourth and fifth are also right in the thick of this. It is a clean run so far for Frances Trespuch, and you would expect with all of her experience and know-how that she would be able to fight through any of the jitters and have the course knowledge and race know-how to avoid trouble. Meantime, there's three battling for the final two spots, and up, there you go. That was the American Megan Tierney, crossed by Italy's Bruto, and the finish is Trespuch. Paul from Olympic athletes from Russia and Italy's Bruto, and no rulings coming down after the race, so those three are safely in to the semifinals, and kind of some bad luck for the two American girls. Certainly Gulini at the beginning and Tierney there right at the end, and there are your next three for the semifinals. Back up to the final quarterfinal. Last six battling for three spots in the semis. Keep your eye on Italy's 22-year-old Michela Moioli. This is a testament to her courage, strength, and will to compete. Remember, there she is, focused, good to go. Remember back in Sochi 2014, gold medal final. Moioli on the bank turn, crosses with Bulgaria's Alexandra Yakova, and after big air here, it's a big crash. And, oh, you can just feel the pain on the mountain. Moioli blows out her knee. Torn ACL, dreams crushed, but not forever. Because here she is, back in the Olympics with a shot at the semifinals. And here we go. And if you have ever seen a world-class athlete totally in her element and in the zone, watch Moioli. She is in the signature Italian blue and white pants, free and clear of any possible trouble. Huge air off the jumps. Moioli just having a blast competing here. You can just sense the joy in her every movement. Back competing, but not only competing, she is pushing the envelope toward what would be an unbelievable return to an Olympic final and possibly a podium. Meantime, right behind her, 16-year-old French girl, Julia Pereira de Sousa. Another story in its early chapter as she momentarily bids for the lead over Moioli, but she cannot care. Doesn't matter. It's the top three, and there's Australia's Belle Brockhoff. So far in good shape, Moioli, Pereira de Sousa, and Brockhoff trying to push. Remember, the third spot is up for grabs. It means a spot in the semifinals. And oh, that's it. That's how it will look. Brockhoff manages to grab the third spot. So it's Moioli, the 16-year-old Pereira de Sousa, and the Aussie Brockhoff moving on to the semifinals. Hope you're enjoying our special drill down of the ladies snowboard cross competition from the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018. Let us know what else you'd like to see in the chat box or down below. And then you see the 16-year-old sticking out her tongue on her way out. Okay, that's fitting. Okay, semifinals. Crowd eagerly anticipating this. What a day. And first, the reigning Olympic champ, Sapkova, right next to her. One of the first snowboard cross Olympic medalists ever, American Lindsay Jacobellis. Of course, it would have been a gold, but a little showboat trick went bad at the finish, so she settled for silver. And now a birthday greeting for her mother.
Happy birthday, Mommy.
This is semis. Three spots available in the gold medal final. Sapkova, obviously the one everyone we'll be chasing, but there are three spots. Time doesn't matter. You just need to finish in the top three. Good clean start. And right off the bat, France's Lacoz with the early lead. Jacobellis riding shotgun right there. Bulgaria's Yakova close behind. Sapkova, the defending Olympic champ, hanging around. Doesn't matter at this point. But as they start to separate, you begin to wonder. Jacobellis is in great shape. Lacoz is rolling free as well. Sapkova is biding her time. But still, very tight. Four and five are right there as well. And now, at this point, Sapkova, the defending gold medalist, is out of position, but then benefits from Lacoz going down. And now it's three for the top three spots. Just stay out of each other's way, and this is a pretty easy slide as long as they can stay upright. You can hear the crowd urging them on. Believe me, the athletes hear it as well. Final jump, big air, and Sapkova, the defending Olympic gold medalist, safely in to the finals. Jacobellis from the U.S., no surprise there, and Yakova from Bulgaria back for another Olympic final. So far so good. Good day at the office for the favorites. It's all gearing up now. Now, the last six for the last three spots, we continue the circuitous, courageous career path of Italy's Michela Moioli, all the way back from the devastating knee injury 4 years ago in Sochi, now hunting a return to the gold medal final. Also, Sochi 2014's bronze medalist, Chloe Trespuch, and a new kid on the board, 16-year-old Julia Pereira de Sousa, both of those last two from France. France starting 1-2 here. But Moioli drafting right behind, feeling comfortable. Moioli easing on down the road, and the air she gets off of her jumps is what stands out. They are 1-2-3 again. The Aussie, Belle Brockhoff in the mix as well. Let's take a moment to appreciate the moving beauty of this sport. Incredible optics. This is how the sport was envisioned, and now here they come. Brockhoff still in the run, still holding strong. These turns can take it out of your legs. This is about avoiding disaster, and then you just have to go for it when you get to the final. Brockhoff broke down in fourth, so these three will now cruise in to the Olympic final. What a feeling, I'm sure, for Michela Moioli. On her way back to where it all began, in a matter of speaking, last Olympics. Sochi blew out her knee, as we mentioned. And again, it's the two French girls, Trespouche and the 16-year-old, Parada de Sousa. On to the final. Pyeongchang 2018 mascot Suhorong posted a DNF in his first race, so he's free to go back to his main mascot function, working the crowd. Defending gold medalist Eva Samkova has loaned out her magic marker, and certainly some of her Czech Republic fans have borrowed it. All right, here we go. Up to the top of the Phoenix Snow Mountain Park track. The final, gold, silver, and bronze on the line for these top-of-the-world snowboarders. Half of the field are past Olympic medalists in this event. 30-year-old Alexandra Yokova, Bulgaria, looking for her first medal. Back for more, Chloe Trespouche. Remember, she bronzed in Sochi. And who isn't rooting for this young Italian? Michela Moioli, back in an Olympic final. The torn ACL, distant memory. Right next to her is the reigning Olympic champion with her lucky mustache, Eva Samkova. Can she become the first to repeat a snowboard cross gold medal? Eldest racer here, 32-year-old American Lindsay Jacobellis, trying to get back to the podium 12 years after her heartbreaking silver in Turin. And half her age, youngest in the event, 16-year-old prodigy Julia Pereira de Sousa. What a race brewing. And we are just about good to go in approximately a minute, 20 seconds. They will have all decided certainly the story of their day and of their Pyeongchang Olympics and maybe of their young life.
Riders ready. Attention.
All boils down to right here and right now. And as you would expect, at the top of the top, amazing side by side, six wide from the jump. Jacobellis in first, barely. Moioli's right there as well. Notice reigning gold medalist Samkova last, sliding backwards. But you know she knows how to finish based on her work in Sochi. As the race develops, look how comfortable and strong Michela Moioli looks in the lead. Worrying about her knee? Not at all. She's going to ease her way down the track, avoids trouble, and makes her move with some big air jumps like right here. Goodbye. She's putting her stamp on this race. Colossal confidence. She could still be caught, but I'm thinking it's going to take an incredible effort by those behind her. In the meantime, the defending gold medalist, she's at this point fourth, fifth, trying to make up ground. She is a fast closer as well. The crowd starting to get into it. Oh my goodness, here it is. The final jump for Moioli, and can she complete the comeback from heartbreak through surgery to the gold medal? And yes, and what a battle right behind her. The silver medalist is the 16-year-old Parada de Sousa from France. And somehow, coming all the way back from way back, the defending gold medalist Eva Samkova manages to come on with a late dive to grab the bronze. What a race. What a day for all those at the Phoenix Snow Park venue in Pyeongchang. And certainly appreciation all the way around. And if you like this stuff, hit us up down below or If you like any other Olympic events, you want to give us some suggestions, go ahead, let us know. The emotion just pouring out. Finally, there's no more races to worry about. The prep has all been finished. And the prep turned into performance, and look at Michela Moioli, incredible. And certainly to the victors go the spoils. First, you're gonna have the flower ceremony at the Phoenix Park venue, a chance for all the fans in attendance and officials to appreciate the moment with these great athletes. And it's not just the top three, it's all six, it's really all 24 who made it through to the knockout rounds. And there is the mustachioed Eva Samkova. How incredible it is to go back to back, just to survive all the way through for 4 years, be healthy, be able to hold off the competition and medal again. And here is that frenzied final finish. And you can only imagine what is coursing through the veins and the heart of Moioli coming all the way back. And yes, there you go. And then after this, of course, the big nighttime party at the Pyeongchang Medal Plaza, where bronze, silver, and gold are officially awarded. What a moment for the girl who wasn't sure she'd ever get back to an Olympic final after blowing out her knee in Sochi.
Gold medal, Olympic champion, Italia, Michela Moioli.
What a moment for her and her family, coaches, the team, the entire nation. Gold around her neck, the dreams realized. And then the most magical moment, aside from crossing the finish line number one and the gold medal, the sound of your national anthem ringing out for the world to hear.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Italy.
Fratelli d'Italia, brothers of Italy, or in this case, sisters. Very rare that an athlete experiences a life-changing injury, perseveres through surgery and rehab, refocuses, retrains, retains her spirit, regains her talented edge, returns to the top, and pushes through to an Olympic gold medal. There's so much more to Moioli's story. Check it out now in the final episode of our original series, Against All Odds, presented by Bridgestone. Just follow the link below or go to OlympicChannel.com anytime. See you again soon.